gonna try it. Before I can try it, I have to clean it all up. It's really oily, and solder on the cylinder cap. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. All right, I've got the piston fitted. It's a little tight, but that's what you want. And then I'll let it'll work itself in with a lot of oil. So I'm gonna Loctite this on, and then set everything up again, and put some air pressure on this, and see if it'll even turn over or do anything. I might have to do a little more work on these plate to fit exactly. And it feels pretty good there. Put another dab of Loctite on this. That's good. I'll set that aside to dry. Now the plans show a hole in here, so I'll go ahead and mark that out and drill that while I'm waiting for that to dry. Disassemble everything. A little steam engine. Here's the frame. This is a little hard to see because it's the sunlight is beaming in through the window and casting some weird shadows, but I need to drill the holes in the bottom to mount it. When you try to drill this way, you're gonna hit the chuck. You can't get in there. You have to go at an angle. So I tried, I was just gonna punch them with my little metal punch, and I couldn't get in there. Same reasons. It hits the body of the punch before you even get to the hole puncher. So I said, oh, I'll just flip it upside down. I wanted to hold these parallels, so it's slanted. Put this on parallels. Well, you can't drill through parallels. You'll ruin your drill bit. These are hardened steel. So I cut a piece of wood. And then I'm holding this all down. Isn't that overkill, all that for a little piece of metal? Sheet metal, when you cut through with the drill bit, it tends to grab right at the end, and it'll sling it out of your hand, cut your hand, or bend your work. Usually it'll just hang on and just swing around and ruin it. So that's why I've tied this down with the 1-2-3 blocks, the T-nut holder, so that it can't cause any damage. I just cut a piece of wood to use as a backup block to tear up the drill bit, and I had a punch mark in there, so the drill bit's fine in the punch mark. All there is to it. Everybody's happy, nobody's fingers got cut, and it didn't ruin the part. That's one. Oh, I gotta mark this one out. We'll do that one later, but I want to get this one finished and running. Right, so you notice I have the cylinder assembly back over here in the south bend. What I found was when I assembled everything that the faceplate and the cylinder had a sizable gap. So I'm like, how do I get rid of that? So what I had to do, I already had this 1/8 inch pivot pin screwed and Loctited in, so I had to heat it up and take it out. And then I was able to chuck the cylinder assembly in the 3-jaw because of its length and the way its little ears stick out each side and they're flat. And the 3 jaws are just enough to grab the cylinder and hold it while allowing the flat plate to press up against the jaws, guaranteeing that they're perpendicular to the lathe bed. So then I could come in here to get a real smooth cut. I move the belt up to the higher speed. So higher speed, slow feed. I got a real smooth finish on there. And then I took one of these high speed steel cutting bits, put the 600 grit, and just moved it over there real carefully, holding it perfectly parallel. And I think I fixed it. We'll assemble it all back together and see if it'll run. You see how that fits in there? The extension on either side of the cylinder to keep it flat. And just enough to hold it. Anyway, it worked. Back over to the workbench. I got these on here for heat sinks. I don't want to desolder the whole plate. I'm trying to see if it went all the way around the gap there. Looks like it did. Alright. Okay, it's ready to test run. Top is soldered on. Went ahead and put the output coupler on. So there's the picture. This is the entire drawing. It's missing a lot of dimensions. For instance, the bore and stroke, the size of these holes, the size of the shaft. There's no shaft sizes in here. That just shows a picture. I used an eighth inch. There it is. Got the air compressor hooked up, and I'm running about 20 on there, but I've got the valve here, needle valve. I can set the pressure. There it goes. Yeah, it wants to go. Half inch stroke and a little over 3/8 bore. This one I bored out. It's 420, 0.420, 420 bore. And that's ready to drive a prop. Now I have to build a boat. Got a prop for it. Got this on eBay. It's a three-bladed prop. Pretty cool looking. Put it on a shaft. Be ready to drive a boat.